Welcome everyone to Shop Talk. Today is a pretty large Shop Talk. I have a lot of Q&A, so I'm hoping we're kind of changing up the format. So just hang on and we're gonna go through this. Again, my name is Mary Lee Johnson. I'm a technical advisor for Alliant Health Solutions. And Amy Ward is the infection prevention specialist. She'll also be answering questions and she will be manning the Q&A. Answering that. Your agenda for today, again, I've changed our format. So we're gonna talk about what's required as a review. We're gonna talk about some tools that we provide as Alliant Health Solutions to help you submit your data and to understand it better. We're gonna talk about the top frequently asked questions that I've received in October, and there actually is more than 10. I should have changed this number. And then some other resources. So here we go. First thing I want you, if you're new or if you're really fairly new, or you haven't submitted any data in it before into NHSN, this is your go-to slide. This is the basis of what you need to report each week. And we still get questions about what we're supposed to report. I'd love for you to bookmark this. There's a link here that's on the NHSN website that shows you exactly what you're supposed to report. This is also on the web page. It shows the different pathways. So you have your staff, your impact, your resident impact for your pathways, your supplies, and your therapeutics, COVID therapeutics, which do change a lot. And then the other thing that we're supposed to report, we started just a few weeks ago, was mandated to report your COVID vaccine and for your healthcare personnel or your staff and your residents. So that's mandated and it's every week. So you have to report all of A and B every week and no more than 7 days apart. So within 7 days, you can report more often, which for the A section is easy to do. However, for the B section, the problem is there's only one field that pops up. So you would have to go back to that field or that screen, that page. And then the C part, the point of care testing reporting tool, that is not mandated that you put that your positive and negatives into NHSN, but you have to send that information within 24 hours to your health department, either way, except for Georgia. They have now made it mandated. So you have to put, if you live in Georgia and work in Georgia, then you have to put this in NHSN. So find out from your health department. If we find out, we will let you know. But if your health department has switched and made this a law, you need to find that out and be ready for it. And remember, you would have to have level 3 access to put point of care data in. And I know this slide is very tiny on your screen, but hold on to these. I have a lot of links that are important, like since the beginning, basically, of in March 2020, when the links came out and the mandates came out as to what you're supposed to report and the guidance from CDC. So what is new, there's not been any memos from CMS since our last Shop Talk that I can remember, or I don't have any. But what we do have new for this time, and I have the little lightning bolt here to show you what's new, and that's the tracking sheets. Remember how they've changed your vaccine module, your healthcare personnel module categories for the staff. So now there's a new tracking sheet. So you want to hang on to that. And also down here, the CDC, what's new and updated, that's the link that you would find, you know, booster changes in booster mandates and all of the other mandates that come up from CDC. That's a good link to hang on to. And now I'm going to just step back a little bit to help you understand how to find the information that you need to find to report your data. You have so many things, so many competing priorities. I understand that. NHSN's website has gotten really large and there's a lot of information and it's organized, but you almost have to know how it's organized to find anything. So if you don't choose to save the web page, that is fine. I'm showing you, you can just type in the letters NHSN and it should pop up as one of your first first things on Google. Now that's not the case if you type in Sam's, obviously the bulk discount store shows up. But for NHSN, this types up and it shows the web page and it should get you to the important things. If you type in long-term care facilities, these items on the left are important for you to know. It's where you can log in. The top one that I have circled, NHSN login, is where you would go in to log in to get to the database. This next one shows you the CMS requirements. I think that's important. You might want to put that up high somewhere in your office. Nail it to the wall. Changes, if you leave your facility or if you go to a new facility, you need to know how to change your access to the new facility, or you need to know how to gain facility access if no one has access. So that's that change in NHSN facility administrator page. You need to know where that is. And then the two basic ones down here are your long-term care COVID-19 module information and your healthcare personnel and resident vaccine, COVID-19 vaccine information. Really need to keep up with, we try to give you the updates, but sometimes these updates happen before our monthly shop talk. So please try to check these pages as much as you can so that you won't be in shock when you get to put your data in and realize there's all new information. For the Alliant Quality website, if you type into our alliantquality.org website, the way you would find all of our shop talks and information, it's a little confusing, but if you browse by topic and then click NHSN shop talks NHSN, you will get to all of our shop talks and our shop talk shorts. We are in the process of revising and revamping to make it easier for you to get to our resources. But just know that we do have these resources and they are supposed to supplement what is on the NHSN website. They're always that their website's the go-to, but ours is additional information and support. Here is our Shop Talk Shorts YouTube channel. We stole this from Pixar. Like, these are short videos that are that last like 2 minutes to explain many of the frequently asked questions. Our most popular question is, help, I'm new and no one has access to NHSN. That's the first one. So if you were to go to our playlist down here, you could find these answers. Another one is, can I use my grid card to access a new facility? I explain how to do that, even how to change your email address, because it's not straightforward. You have to change it in two places. So, and the newest one, Amy has created the how do I generate a report in NHSN to see my vaccine data and the date submitted. So please check those out. That will help answer questions, many of the questions. Another thing, we have a playlist for all our shop talks. So if you weren't able to attend, you can always go to our playlist and listen to the shop talk or even just the parts you're interested in. And remember, if you would like your facility to have technical assistance from us, it's really important that you join our group. And we want you to continue to email NHSN as well as us, because that is your document for CMS. But email us as well, and we will try to get to you as quickly as we can. But the way we can look up your information that you've submitted to see if it's correct or if you need help is you would join our group and you would go to group, join, and then type in the password up here is the group ID, password, and the group name. So that's how you would, and then you would click join and then accept. So we hope that if there's any of you there that have not joined our group, you will go ahead and join. So now we'll begin the question and answer series. So I've divided, I have listed, I guess it's 18, so that's more than 10, isn't it? But there's just been a lot of questions lately. And I categorized them into three sections. One are just general questions about NHSN and access. The second group is this new, the changed, revamped vaccine module where they changed the healthcare personnel categories. There has been lots of glitches with that, so I've tried to answer a lot of those questions. And then the last, there's a few that were about the point of care module that I thought were important. And also I want to note that we put in the chat, there's going to be a new training from NHSN next week. So you want to sign up for that. That'll go into more in depth. So for now, let's just start at the beginning. These are real questions that were submitted in our inbox. So I literally just took them straight from questions that were asked to me. So I hope this will be helpful to go through them. The first question, I have a user who was transferred from another center and has lost her grid card and can't recall her password. The only thing I can see is that she can call the SAMS help desk and work with them to reset all her information or most likely wipe out her old account and start over again. Check with you before I start down this road. The answer, unfortunately, is if you don't know your password and you don't know the answers to your security question so that you can reset your password, then you do have to call the SAMS help desk and ask them to terminate your account. Then you're going to need to ask, send an email to NHSN to get invited again and start over the whole process. How would you prevent that from happening? You can go into your SAMS profile, which I highly recommend, go into modify your identity data and print and modify, and in that part, it's going to include the answers that you had typed in originally for your security questions. So print that out somewhere and save it in a secure place. That way you'll be able to type in, because it's case sensitive. So in my example, my first car was burgundy, but if I type in little letters burgundy, it really should be capital B. So I wouldn't, if I typed in the little letter instead of the capital letter, it wouldn't work. So you know, how am I supposed to remember that I did that? I don't, so I have it printed out. The next question is, our newest staff member has lost her card. She's emailed them, but wanted to know if there was a quicker way to replace it. So this is a different question. She's lost her card, but she hasn't forgotten her password or security questions. All she needs is another card. And this is easy. You do just have to reach out to SAMS. You can call them or email them. Probably better to call them in this case, and they will mail you another card. And as long as your mailing address is the same as the one you signed up originally for in your SAMS profile, then it will be mailed to your mailbox, and it shouldn't take more than a couple of days. The next question I see, I received this week, please help me and sister facilities get NHSN level 3 access. Remember how the beginning of this month they sent an email out saying you have to, you know, as soon as possible get your level 3 or you're not going to be able to submit your data. Well, since then NHSN did rescind that, and they created kind of a backdoor way to set up that monthly plan, so you weren't required this week or next week, but it is going to happen soon. So what you need to do is reference our Shop Talk short, but in a nutshell, you need to send an email to nhsn@cdc.gov and put increasing SAMS level access or enhancing security access. Any of those phrases will get you on the process to get your level 3. Next question I received was, I was hoping you could assist. My NHA got herself locked out of NHSN on Friday and then realized she had never officially set up her own account with SAMS or NHSN. She was using the original one from our prior nursing home administrator and had just changed the password. We are now starting over, and I wondered if there was anything I could do to, or if you could assist to help this get done quicker. Well, unfortunately, there's nothing you can do. So when you sign up to, in the SAMS access, you're signing up as yourself. So if you're using someone else's password, that's not appropriate. So the SAMS help desk has no choice but to, they have to terminate it. I mean, that's the law, the HIPAA law. So what you're gonna do at this point is the way you would start over is you would have to send, you could fill out, well, I think I've got a couple of answers here. You're going, there's no shortcut. So the steps you're gonna have to do is first you have to recognize, get SAMS, you have to get a SAMS application. The only way you can get a SAMS application for yourself is to fill out this change in administrator form that I had briefly mentioned early on. So you're gonna go to that, to the main website, click on the change in admin form. You're gonna fill out all of that information that says you're the current administrator with your email address that you wanna set up with, and it can't be a generic email. Then you're gonna get that invitation to register. And to speed things up, you should email, follow up an email with NHSN because we wanna communicate as clearly as possible and state all of your appropriate information that you need an invitation to register. And if, since you don't have level 3 and no one's there that's gonna be able to submit data, I would request a level 1 access. That way, if you request a level 1, then you would be able to have access to your facility account and you wouldn't have to wait the 2 weeks to put your data in, you know, until you got your SAMS card. So you would want to go ahead and ask for this level 1 to get, so you can put data in quicker, but then you're going to be required to get your level 3 later as soon as you can. We do have a Shop Talk short that addresses this, and you would go to this link, that I am new and no one at my facility has access to NHSN. And we go through this a tutorial, just a couple of minutes to answer a lot of the incidental questions. Another question I received is, I have a facility that the administrator is no longer at this location. I did reach out to her to set me up as a user for NHSN reporting. She indicated that she was never set up with administrative rights and could not set me up. How can I get on this facility account to be able to do their reporting? This happens all the time. Somehow people get access to their facility, but whoever added them didn't give them an administrator rights. So then that means they can't add people in the future. So again, you go back to that same change in administrator form. Even you're not physically changing your role or your job, for NHSN purposes, you have to tell them you need administrator rights. And really the only way to do that in NHSN language is to fill out that change in administrator form. Even if what you're doing is putting, you know, you're saying you're the current administrator. I mean, you're not the current. You have to figure out who was the administrator prior and then put your email address in as the new one. And then you'll automatically get all the rights, the administrator rights. You'll be able to put your point of care testing in and all of that, and you'll be able to add future users. So, and we do have a Shop Talk short for this. I'm new and no one at my facility has access. So you're going to use that same Shop Talk short. Another question, please help me. I have added 2 users for my facility, and these people already have SAMS access. They're showing as users for my facility, but both say they cannot access the facility input information. I am no longer working at that facility, and with changes, it is getting harder for me to input the information. Please help with this or lead me in the right direction. So in this case, these 2 new users, they have put data in the past at some other facility. So they have their SAMS card, but somehow they don't have access to this facility. And she added them, she or he added them. What could be wrong? And I know it's frustrating, but there's a mystery that we need to solve. And in this case, it turned out that when she had added them as a user, she put in their profile, she clicked on for user active, she clicked no. So it looked like to NHSN that these people, while they were added, they didn't need to have access anymore. They had been deactivated. So what she needed to do was just go back into the profile and change it to yes. Along the same lines, another problem it could have been is she typed in their email address incorrectly, or their SAMS login did not match their NHSN email address. So those need to match. So all these things need to match for them to show that they have access. They may have been granted access or given access, but their emails have to match on the SAMS credential side and the NHSN side. Another question, I added two users and neither have received their invitation to register. What do I do? So back to this first, did you make sure the user profile was active? And, you know, in this case, oh no, I didn't. So, okay, so both clicked as not active. Now we've corrected that. And now what do we do? So we corrected it. Does she need to email NHSN to get this invitation? And yes. So once she switched it to active, if the person does not already have a SAMS card, then they're going to need to finish their application. And the only trigger would be that you send an email to NHSN. And in my case, this is Oscar the Grouch. So please send, this is the format you can use that you would let NHSN know they need to send you an invitation to register, which means just get your application started. I want you to remember that whatever email you use, you need to check that inbox regularly to see if you received the invitation. It's going to be coming from sams-no-reply@cdc.gov. It'll have the subject line, SAMS Partner Portal Invitation to Register, and it very likely could go to your spam or your junk mail. So you want to check that regularly. If you haven't received it in 2, 3, or 4 days, you need to send another email and hopefully copy your ticket number that you received from that generic reply. You're always going to get a generic reply from NHSN. Okay, we'll move on to some of the more pressing questions that we've had this week where people were not able to save their data because of glitches. There were several. I counted, I think there were 6 glitches for the past couple of weeks that prevented you guys from saving your data. So let's just talk about how to remedy these so you don't go through that stress again. One question that I did receive that was a little bit different than the weekly, but there is there a way to import test results into NHSN, or do we have to put them in individually? Someone asked this question. They were actually referring to the point of care testing, but it applies to any of the modules you can import with a CSV file. However, there's a template for each one, so you're gonna have to be meticulous with that template. Download the CSV file, make sure each field is answered correctly according to the guidelines from the template. The glitch for this week that happened that we had not seen before is that for the weekly vaccine modules, you could not upload the CSV file unless you had a level 3 access. So if you weren't using that level 3 access to upload, it would give you an error. And NHSN recognized this error. They sent a message as soon as they found out, and they said they would upload it for you if you sent an email to them. They did not say that they didn't give you a timeline or time frame. So a reminder for this level 1 versus level 3, which I know is terribly confusing, but when you're logging in, if you have level 3 access and you originally had level 1, you're always going to see both sections to be able to click on to access. Just the bottom section that says NHSN LTC reporting, it really needs to go away. You should never need to log, you should never log in there anymore because it's not going to give you access to all the things that you signed up for with your level 3. So please try to remember to submit, click on the NHSN reporting. Instead of the NHSN LTC reporting. And just as a reminder, you can, if you get hung up, you want to use this fresh link, https://sams.cdc.gov, to go in. You can save that browser. It's better not to save it because the cookies and the cache get all mixed up in your history. So, and that's not cash money, that is the cache in your computer. So I would recommend either going to the main website and clicking on NHSN application to log in, or typing in a fresh link each time. And if you have level 3, you're going to want to go straight to your grid card. You're not going to want to have saved any of your passwords with Google. That gets things confused. Remember, that's where you're going to log in, the top, not the bottom. And okay, this is another question. I don't know if any of you guys have seen this error. I saw it personally, so this is why I'm putting it in. I'm receiving this error message. I'm not able to submit my vaccine data. So the error message was no monthly reporting plan exists. If you see that, typically what you would need to do is go back in and add your reporting plan. Because NHSN added the reporting plans behind the scenes and did not require you to add it, then you don't need to do anything. But if you're like me and you go in and you mess with things, I did that. So I messed with it. What I did was I clicked, just to see what would happen, I clicked this top box here that says, no long-term care facility component module followed. I wanted to see if you could click it and unclick it and be able to add the reporting plan in, because I remember from years ago that is a common mistake that facilities had, is they accidentally clicked that instead of the actual reporting plan. Well, if you click that button, you're going to be frozen out. You're not able to go back in. If you click it and save it, you're not going to be able to add your reporting plan, and it's going to be frustrating. You'll have to call, you'll have to email NHSN and get them to fix it for you. That's what I had to do because I couldn't fix it. So don't click that button. So that's the shiny button. Do not click that button. On another note though, just make sure you see how the weekly COVID vaccination module, if you go into the reporting plan section, it's this really gray, very faintly, this faint gray box that's checked. That's what you want to make sure is checked. If that is the case, you should not have any problems. The next question, I'm having difficulty imputing data into the healthcare worker portion of the portal. Could you please assist? My data is due Wednesday. I think it was Wednesday when I got this. So that's really stressful. It may have happened to you guys. So, here's how you may have already figured out, but just in case you didn't figure out how to do it and get it to save successfully, it's basically the new math. So all the numbers in row 1 for each category, for each of the 4 categories, all the numbers must in the rows for 2 and for 3 must equal the top number in row 1. So you have to include those that have had 1 dose plus those that have had 2 doses. You don't add in that any completed in the series. That's an automatically calculated number. Don't add that one. Just everybody that had 1 dose, everybody that had 2 dose of each of the vaccines. And then you're going to add in if you have put anybody that had a medical contraindication, or if they offered but declined the vaccine, and if they're unknown. See, before it didn't matter about these numbers as much to get everything to save, but now it does. So both of these numbers must equal the top number. And you're going to do this for each column. So you did that for employees. Now you're going to do it for the licensed physicians or practitioners, the same thing. And the third column, the adult and student volunteers, and then your contract personnel, the same thing. So I have an example. You're gonna of numbers. If we feel like we need to, if we want, or if you want us to do an example in real life, we can open up our test facility. If you're okay with this, then we'll move forward. But if anybody, you know, wants us to do this in real time, we can. If you're trying to put your data in and you can't, and it just keeps saying it, you just keep getting the error message, and you want to send it to Amy or I or NHSN, you can send to all three. We would need all of these numbers, and we were getting screenshots with just some of these numbers, but there's no way we could figure it out. So you need to send all of the numbers to us so we can use our test facility to figure out what may be wrong, and we can help you with your. So this is that error message. The sum of questions 2 and 3 must equal 1, and it tells you which category has the problem, like employees. So you know which one to go to get fixed. So in this example, it was an arithmetic error, and I went, I think, I had to do some finagling. I think originally, if you had added all these numbers up, it came up to 170 instead of 165 or 167 instead. It's hard for me to do math in front of everybody. So what I had to do was I had to go back through and change what needed to be changed so that it would equal the 165. And then I changed. So remember, you're not going to add the auto-populated field or the any completed, I spelled it wrong, COVID-19 vaccine series. But you want to make sure all these columns, and this is an example you can go by, to see where I had errors, and I went back in and corrected those errors. And after I fixed all of these numbers, let's see what happened. So I went back in, I fixed the numbers, I made the corrections, still haven't saved it yet. Then I tried to hit save, and then what happened? I got another error just as I got all of those numbers. My booster number was incorrect. So what I had to do was, it says the section 5 exceeded the number for section 4 in the same column. So my additional boosters that I'd given was higher than the number that were eligible to receive the booster. So that's why I got another error. You want to make sure you correct that. And then once I corrected that number, made sure that it did not exceed, then I was able to save. So I imagine that some of you went through that frustration. So I hope this cleared up some of the math and where you would need to change it. And the same happens in the resident vaccine data. It's a little less categories, right? But you still have to make sure everything adds up appropriately, or you'll get the error message. Another error that people received was this null value. And this was a little more of a mystery. What happened was many facilities were sending the same question. I'm getting this error. I don't know what it is. How do I stop it? And when I would share screens, the only thing we could figure out was to get out of NHSN, log out of the whole thing, and then go back in and put the same numbers in, and it worked. We didn't know why that was working, but that worked. So what happened was, what NHSN said to do was, let's see, here's their answer. This is verbatim from them. So if you get that null value, it means that what was happening, I have a shot here. This part down here where it says the booster, it was auto-populating, I don't have the screen, but your different boosters. So what you would make sure of, and I don't have a screenshot, I'm sorry. But each of those boosters at the very bottom should not auto-populate. So if they're auto-populating, it's going to give you that null value. So what you want to do is hit the trash can for each of those boosters, throw them away, and then resubmit it. And it may take you going all the way out, clearing, it says, I'll read it. It says, we recommend that you select the trash can icon next to the vaccine type, close the module, and then reopen it. Or entering your COVID-19 vaccination data. The other solution, if the issue persists after following these instructions above, we recommend you log out of NHSN, clear your browser cookies, close your browser before attempting to enter the data again, and then send an email if you continue to have a problem with this glitch. And another question that was worrying people was, I have an alert from NHSN about the vaccine reporting from last week. Please let me know when you have a few minutes to answer. What it looks like is I have a QA alert. When I pull it up, it gives me the reporting page from the week before saying my vaccine numbers were less than 10%. And that did happen, and that was worrisome for people that don't like alerts popping up in their face, which me, I always want to clear all my alerts. But the answer was, hello, thank you for this message. We have recently discovered an issue with the quality assurance alerts that appear on your screen in the application. We are working on this to resolve it. So in a nutshell, just disregard those alerts until they can get them worked out. So don't worry about those. But at least you have this, you know that you don't have to worry about it. And hopefully you can just let that go until they fix it. Another one, and this is, I know it's long, but we have a question about the COVID-19 reporting module. We report on Wednesdays. That's just the day we chose and have been reporting on this day for a while. But this morning we reported for 10-4 through 10-10 and it turned green. But for some reason, when we did this, it turned the next week, yellow. We are concerned because yellow is coded as record incomplete. It's not due yet, but we've just never noticed this before. Did we do something wrong? You know, are we in compliance? And it was a little scary because you haven't seen that happen. Well, here's the answer. I'll summarize it. You'll have this in your documents. Since there's a reporting plan required, it's going to flag and give you an alert for the subsequent weeks in the month that you created your reporting plan. So that yellow is basically just an alert, the way they have set this up. So again, don't worry about it. Just know that it's going to be yellow for the future week. So see, that's what it's going to look like. Once you submit your data, like they did for 10-4 to 10-10, it's going to automatically put in yellow. So that just means the next week you'll need to go in and answer it. Is there an updated spreadsheet? I hope you guys know by now that there is an updated tracking sheet, and here's the link. So this data, please download this or save this new tracking sheet. Try to get all of your data from the previous tracking sheets copied over into the sheet. You may have to finagle it. We have heard just before I got on this call, there's some facilities having trouble and there's a glitch with saving it. I haven't had time to troubleshoot that yet, but try to get your data put in the new sheet so you will more easily be able to put your answers, your data in, and not have as many errors. Another thing is, are you required? Oh, this was kind of important one that was causing worry. Are you required to submit missed and incomplete vaccine data from prior weeks? And the answer is yes. So if you get a CMP fine or a notice where you've missed a week, you do need to get that one in, and that will resolve your penalty, but you are required to go back and get all of the week's data, the prior weeks in, within a timely manner. So that's that answer. And then the last one, I think this is close to the last one. Your weekly COVID-19 vaccine module question. We have created a Shop Talk short to show you how to do this, but we want you to create and generate a new data set and pull this report regularly, hopefully each week, to make sure your data is in the system and it looks correct. We want your percentages to look correct because you want to reflect that, because this is going to a publicly reported website where other people are looking at your data, the public, or besides CMS, you know, news reporters or whomever, residents, future residents, people are looking at this, so it needs to reflect accurately. And we have created a Shop Talk to show you how to do that. So Just check your rates each week to ensure accuracy. And they're uploaded. If you want to go to the website on cmsdata.gov, you can see them there. They're uploaded each Thursday for the prior week. But it may take a little while to see your newest data. It takes they're like 2 weeks behind. Okay, we'll move on to the point of care testing module. And again, there's going to be training next week, but this was a recent question. I'm trying to edit the staff ID for an existing staff member, but when I change the ID, the message says I cannot find staff. See the screenshots. How do I edit this field and change and save? Well, you can't change the ID. So you would have to delete their profile. And in the frequently asked questions that NHSN has on their website, they address this. And I know when you're putting your data in, there's just so much to keep up, but there's so many places to look for answers. So this is just to help you remember that you can't change their ID or their visitor ID. You've just got to delete the whole profile and put everything back in with the new ID. That's the way, it's a safety mechanism, the way they set up the point of care profile. And this one I thought was exciting because we have diversity, and NHSN allows you to select multiple races. And this was a real question that was asked to me. And so I didn't even know the answer. So when I looked it up, you can select multiple races. So, and if the resident or is not a good historian, please check, with a close family member, and you can edit it later on if you want to change it. But I thought that was pretty cool that you could select multiple races. And remember, this is where you want to, check your rates on Medicare, the new, updated Care Compare website. For example, this is one facility's rate. If you clicked on this link and you noticed that yours said, resident vaccination was 20%, that would be a big flag. Oh no, we've put something wrong in NHSN. Well, I don't want this to ever happen to you. I want you to go into NHSN before that and generate your reports and double check. If you're new to long-term care infection prevention, these are pages I recommend bookmarking. You can always email us. You can email Amy, and I don't know why I did not put her name here, but you can email her, and we'll give you that contact information if you have any questions. Either one of us can put your contact information into our database, our Salesforce, so you'll get updated emails about our education. And here, just frequently, this bookmarks that you need, your mandates, the NHSN website, the different modules, and our shop talks. And this is if you don't have access to NHSN and you've never had access and don't want it, and other people in your facility have access, that's great. But I still recommend, even if you're not one of the users, I still recommend you getting the email updates, because you still need to know you need to keep up with what's going on. They don't send very many updates at all, but they are important when they send them. So that you would go to this link, you would scroll down on the left side and put your email address in, how to get updates. And this is also important for people that have used their personal email for their SAMS access, and they might not look at their personal email for updates. So then you could put your work email here so that you would be notified while you're at work. And that way you wouldn't miss out on something that was important from an agency. Mark your calendar. We do have these shop talks once a month. Unless something comes up, we give a shop talk office hours like we did last month. But they're the third Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern time. And here are the links for the next two. We should be coming up with new links for January, but you can save the date in the meantime. Okay, so thank you for your time today. Our goal is to be helpful and supportive for you and your NHSN data submissions and infection prevention and CDC guidance. Here's our contact information, mine, Amy's. Please send us emails or mail. We will try to help you as quick as we can. There's just a couple of us, so we do our best to get to you as soon as possible. Thank you for everything you guys do. We are happy to support you, and we hope you have a happy Halloween later on. And just thank you for your participation. Hope you have a great rest of your day.